slow you down. Where are you from? And the choice to go to Morehouse, where did that come from for you?
Well, you know, I'm from Richmond, Virginia, and I tell my story to some of the young men, and yes, I'm a part of the 100 Black Men of DC as well. Mm-hmm. And I really didn't know a whole lot about college. You know, I had older siblings. Mother raised five kids by herself in Richmond, Virginia. She didn't go to college. My older siblings didn't go to college. And one day when I was in high school, and they made us go to this college fair. Mm-hmm. And they actually had a ton of colleges there. And I didn't know anything about Morehouse. I didn't know anything about the legacy, the history, any of that. No, not at all. I was, you know, an average student, and I didn't really press myself doing high school. Mm-hmm. So I go around this, it was at the Arthur Ashe Center, you know, mm-hmm. Arthur Ashe is from Richmond, Virginia. Okay. And so I come across this school in Atlanta. It's like, well, you know, okay, all male school, African-American school, mm-hmm. still really didn't know the history of it. And so when it came time for me applying to schools, I applied to only two schools because I just didn't know any better.
Okay.
J. Sargent Reynolds Community College in Richmond and Morehouse.
Wow.
And I applied to Morehouse really because it was out of Richmond, Virginia, and was far away, and that I could go somewhere where I didn't know anyone, mm-hmm. not knowing that that choice would impact my life.
Mm-hmm. It would.
Immensely, mm-hmm. you know, just two schools, J. Sargent Reynolds Community College in Richmond versus going to Morehouse, which really helped me become that man that I am now, to serve as that foundation of seeing, I would call it Black excellence. And you see people that look like you that mm-hmm. not only in history class, but also in religion and music and philosophy, you're being taught by someone that looks like you and teaching you the Afrocentric perspective mm-hmm. on things. So to give you that, I guess, push to not think that you're competing, quote, with someone else, but you're competing with yourself and say that you are that person.
Yes. Actually, Dr. B.K. Edmond is a cardiac anesthesiologist who, I think he's class of 88 or 86 from Morehouse School of Medicine. And he said the same thing. He said he's from a small town in Georgia, but he said what happened at Morehouse was that the race element went away. So when the professor said, you can't say you didn't get a good grade because I didn't relate to you, it's because you didn't write a good paper.
Right.
And so I actually took a class, Black Male Writers, 20th Century, at Morehouse. And so I was able to cross register there. It was the most impactful class that I had taken in my college career. And I was at Agnes Scott College, a predominantly white school in Decatur, Georgia. And we got to read some very powerful books. And we also read books like Imp the Pimp by Iceberg Slim. I'm like, you want me to read this? Like, absolutely, because who says this is not literature?
Right.
I said, well, all right, then we're going to read this.
a powerful thing that one of my professors, Dr. Jane Braithwaite, said. He,
yes.
One of the students said, you know, we have to get out and work twice as hard. And then he said, let me stop you right there. So when you say that we have to get out and work twice as hard as them, you're giving them credit that they're working hard at all.
There you have it. There you have it.
So we have that in our own mindset that it's more than that.
Yes.
We're running from behind out of the starting blocks when we look at equity, whether it's health equity, social equity, educational equity.
That's right. Thank you so much for taking some time to explain that.